need to learn how to talk to a lady. Ask your mum.
Hey there, I just thought I'd do a really quick video on my purse storage situation here. I don't have as many purses as a lot of other people on YouTube, and they're definitely not all luxury, but still, they're mine, and you know, it's nice to have a place to put your things. So I keep most of my purses here in my little purse cabinet thing here. They start up here at the top. Ignore the popcorn ceiling. It's an old house. Of course, up there you have the dupe, then the Louis Vuitton Samour 35. I just have just some random stuff in the basket up there, and I have to figure out a better way to store my scarves. Okay, so then of course you have Louis Vuitton, Coach, Louis Vuitton, and Antihoo. Over here we have Libeskind. I really love their purses. They, it's just, this leather is so nice. Let's see, so this is the Libeskind Esther. This is the bag from Zara. I love this bag. I actually won it when the Luxury Hybrid had her 3,000 subscribers giveaway. I willed this bag into existence, y'all. This I willed it into my life. This one over here, this direction, thank you. This is Coach, obviously. And then just like a little few like random Coach things and stuff right in there. Going down to the next shelf, this bag is from International Concepts. I got this from Macy's. I think it was originally $100 and I paid $40 something for it. The one in the back, that is vintage. It's a vintage clutch from the Philippines. It's from the either the 70s or the early 80s. This bag is just a bucket bag that I bought at DSW. And then of course I have like random like china and glassware and teacups and things like that all over the place. Sort of product of how I grew up. But this I think I just got at Home Goods, but I thought it was so pretty. And then this is Hermes. I need to get another one of these because I don't want to be that person that, you know, if somebody comes over for tea, I get the Hermes one and then they get some random. Actually, knowing me though, I would give them this one. But that's just me. Down here, the newer acquisitions, again, more Hermes. And then that is BCBG. My mom bought me that. And I love that purse. I love the handles on it. It's always great. And then down here on this shelf, just a couple of books that I have. Some of them are like Louis Vuitton. This is a pop-up book and it's amazing, and I got that from one of my best friends. She surprised me with it as a gift and it's one of my favorites. But I have a ton of books, and one of my goals in life is to just have my own personal library at home, like a huge, huge library room. I have a ton of books. They're all in boxes in the garage because I don't have any place to put them at the moment. This is a train case that belonged to my grandmother, and she actually left it for me when she passed away. This, I don't have an exact date on it because the company that made this particular style for quite a few years. And so this could be from the 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s, or 60s. My grandmother was born in 1919, so I pretty much ruled out the 20s for this one. If anything, she had it either in the late 30s or she had it in the 40s or 50s. So, like I said, this one is really hard to date because they make the exact same style for such a long time. So that is that. And then down here is where I keep, I keep all of my receipts in here, like from Louis Vuitton and Hermes and all that stuff. They stay in here. There's another one underneath that has stationery. This is stationery. Those are some Chanel body stuff from like 10 years ago. The cream is empty. The powder, there's still some powder left in that for some reason. And then I keep watches in here, and then I do still have a watch in here. My dad and I have matching Russian divers, and that watch is enormous. Fun fact, I rarely wear watches anymore because my body tends to burn out the batteries. I'm one of those people, and it's always been that way ever since I was a little kid. So if I do wear a watch, it's basically for just for show. It's not gonna work. Over in here is where I keep a few more handbags. This is a vintage piece that my aunt bought me. And then this is from Neiman Marcus. I can't remember who makes this bag. Ignore my nails and pants. I'm having a puffy day. This right here is Karl Lagerfeld. Love this bag. This is just a camera bag that I got at TSW. And then this one is International Concepts again. And of course it's kind of like a Chanel bag. So yeah, so there's that. Turn this way, please. In here, I really just keep just extra like small leather goods and wallets and things that I'm just not using at the moment. And then these are just random pouches, like makeup pouches and things of that nature. I have purses in a few other places here too, but I just don't have any place to put these. I really just don't. So yeah, so that is my situation at the moment. Just doing what I can with what I have. So yeah, that is it for now. Let me know what you think. If anybody has any storage suggestions, let a system know. Yeah, when I get into a bigger space again, I plan on having just a full-on dressing room, closet room, however you like to refer to it. And yeah, someday I'll have lots of room again. But today ain't that day. Okay. I hope that you're all doing well. Enjoy your Saturday, and I will see you soon. Bye.